Modding is when you start with an existing game made by someone else and do something to change it. The change can be to the game's design, its visuals, the way it works technically, or all of the above. As you probably know, modding is a huge phenomenon in the gaming community, where creators make original mods and then make them available to other players. Player-created mods are so popular that they've been downloaded billions of times. Many commercial game developers build modding support right into their games, making it easier for players to create and share mods and giving them another way to engage with the game. In fact, a few massively successful commercial games you may have played actually started as mods of other games. Modding is also a great way to get into game design, game making, and coding. If you've ever played a game and had an idea for how you could make it better, you've taken the first step towards creating a mod. You've also acted very much like a game designer. When you play a game and think about what you might change about it, what's working, what isn't, what you'd like to see more or less of, you're playing the game critically, which is an essential game designer skill. When you're learning game making, including modding projects in what you do is a great idea and offers something unique over, say, only taking a course or making original game projects from the ground up. Because you're starting with an existing game when you mod, you can take advantage of something that, from a design perspective, already functions successfully as a complete game experience. And from a technical perspective, you can take advantage of all the complex, interconnected systems the original game makers have put together to make the game work. Building on these foundations lets you isolate what you're trying to accomplish with your mod, both from a creative and a technical standpoint. You don't have to design or implement every single part of the game. You only need to change or extend the parts related to your mod. Doing this still requires and lets you develop the same skills in coding, design, art, and so on that any game maker needs. For these reasons, we often use modding activities when we teach game making. For new game makers and coders, we find it's often helpful to start with a working game and then use a modding activity focused on just the design or coding concepts that we're trying to teach. This usually makes everything clearer and results in a more fun, more sophisticated end product. And believe it or not, working like a modder is very similar to the way professional game makers work. This is because on professional teams, no one person does everything. Most of the time, individual team members are working on one small piece of the game at a time. They rely on the work that others have done, build on top of it, and have to make sure their work integrates with the rest of the game. These are exactly the same things a modder needs to do, and this is another reason why making games is a team sport.